Wolverine is the largest member of the weasel family, a powerhouse of muscle, tooth, and claw. Like its cousins, it's a strong, fearless, and cunning predator. No animal hunts adult Wolverine, but unfortunately, its fur was once valuable. Although no longer trapped here, the Wolverine is still rare. The return of the gray wolf is one of the park's most remarkable success stories. Arguably, the wolf is the most misunderstood and persecuted animal on our continent. In the early 1900s, the native population of wolves was exterminated by hunters and trappers. For 50 years, there were no resident wolves in Glacier. But in 1986, a single pack crossed into the park, selected a den, and raised a litter of pups. Now there are about 30 wolves here. To the hunters who see them as competition, and the ranchers who fear for their livestock, the presence of wolves is controversial. For the time being, the wolf has reclaimed a home in this wilderness. Glacier's peaks, winter lingers until June. But as the lower valleys ease toward spring, the risk of avalanches increases. Waterton Glacier loosens its bonds of ice. The first warm breath of spring rouses the sleeping grizzlies. The mother and her new cub will remain inseparable for more than 2 years. Predator may take predator. To the mountain lion or cougar, the tiny bundle of bear must look like an easy meal, but nobody challenges a mother grizzly. This cougar family will stick to its usual diet of deer and elk. An adult moose is too large for a cougar, but not for a big grizzly. Mountain goats are born well before the snows have gone. Alpine meadows to the low-lying prairies, it's spring in Waterton Glacier. The rock face is a dangerous test, even for these agile experts. Cliff swallows have come to collect mud for their nests, but the goats are here to eat it. The salts and other minerals are essential to their diet. Traction is important for these cliffhangers. Spongy pads on their feet and the exceptional splay of their hooves help them hold on. For the new youngsters, the first descent is the most difficult. The adults try to keep the novices safe, but some cannot manage the precipitous cliffs, and accidents rarely go unnoticed by Glacier's scavengers. A yearling investigates the unfortunate victim. Mountain goats may have few predators, but their lives are not risk-free. This nanny brings her kid to easier terrain. The community of animals hiding in prairie grass plays a deadly game. In the badger's hunt for ground squirrels, a ferocious digger is pitted against keen-sighted lookouts. false move by a ground squirrel provides a meal for the badger's family. This red fox also has a family to feed. But while mom is away, the kits are vulnerable. The rescue is clumsy but effective. When the badger heads home, the mother fox can relax and the kits can continue their play. Summer. From June through September, Waterton Glacier is a different world. 2 million people visit the park every year, and most of them come in summer. The park trails are designed to meet the needs of both the tourists and the wild inhabitants. Visitors can catch a glimpse of Glacier's wildlife, like this hoary marmot. Great gray owls would not tolerate millions of people watching as they raise a family, but there are still vast areas of the park without trails and human traffic. Much of Waterton Glacier is still pristine and untouched, a remnant of this continent's natural heritage. Horseback riding has brought something besides people into the park. Horses scatter seeds in their manure, like knapweed, which competes with Glacier's native plants, and in many areas has replaced them. This is reducing the diversity that has made Glacier such a dynamic wilderness. Dandelion and clover are also non-native species, and black bears love them. The plants thrive on the roadsides, bringing bears dangerously close to people. People love to see bears, but many visitors forget that these are wild animals. In the past, that has led bears and people into fatal conflicts. Feeding is now prohibited. The slogan, a fed bear is a dead bear, helps to educate visitors about the problem. If fed, a bear may become an aggressive beggar and have to be shot. With care, encounters like this can be safe and full of wonder. Grizzlies can be found in what might seem to be the most unlikely places. In summer, they'll climb more than a mile to the domain of the golden eagles. Like the Clark's Nutcracker, they've come all this way for a moth. But for the grizzlies, it's a much more difficult journey. Thousands of moths are tucked away in the loose rock. The grizzlies have known about them for generations. Grizzly exploits Glacier's vertical wilderness to the fullest, roaming the park from the prairies to the top of the crown. Wild and natural as it is, Waterton Glacier International Peace Park is not without problems. One concern is the disappearance of the white-barked pines, a major source of food and shelter for a variety of animals. These trees have been badly attacked over the last 80 years by mountain pine beetles and a fungus. Clark's nutcrackers harvest most of the large nutritious seeds, then bury them to eat in winter and spring. But they don't retrieve all the seeds they stash. The nutcracker is the principal agent of seed dispersal for the white-barked pine, and is responsible for most of its regeneration. The pine and the nutcracker have evolved together and are now mutually dependent upon each other. The old pines are dying, and the young ones are slow to replace them. It takes a century for the tree to produce its first seeds. Many areas of the park have lost this essential member of the forest community. The red squirrels also relish the high-energy pine nuts. When available, they concentrate on these seeds, virtually ignoring other sources of food. They'll even guard them from other seed lovers, except for one. Bears dig up the squirrel's cache in autumn. Aspen gold showers down in the autumn breeze. The season's crop of berries lures the mule deer. The antlers of most of the bucks are still sheathed in velvet, though some are already scraping off the irritating soft skin. For 10,000 years, since these valleys became free of ice, the deer, elk, and moose have bellowed and fought in their autumn ruts. A rutting buck is pugnacious. And highly unpredictable. Our world now sits on the edge of theirs. Their homes are fast becoming our homes. The riches of the land around the park, the timber, coal, and oil, are used to fuel our way of life. Yet we need this wilderness. Millions of people come to Waterton Glacier every year to experience not only its scenery, but also the great diversity and majesty of its wildlife. The full complement of predators has returned to the crown of the continent. They are the living epitaph to the bears, mountain lions, bobcats, coyotes, and wolves that North America has so senselessly lost. From the clouds of tiny insects to a single mighty grizzly, from the rich grasslands to the alpine tundra, Waterton Glacier is bursting with life, a continent of diversity in a single park. Perhaps our new knowledge of ecology and park management will enable us to protect it. ¶¶
Nature is made possible by the financial support of viewers like you. Siemens, a whole new world of ideas in electronics and electrical engineering. Siemens. Coming up next, Jackson Hole's the destination for a look at the Grand Teton Wilderness on Nature Next. Then tomorrow, road trip through America with the top down on Travels. Tomorrow night at 7 here on Channel 2.
Decided, let's see how we can make a perfect valley.